Welcome to your Elegant Themes ePanel tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll go through the general features of ePanel. This is the panel that appears on all Elegant Themes for WordPress. Now, once you've logged into your website, you'll find the ePanel under Appearance and go down to Theme Options. It will be the name of your theme and Theme Options. So click on that. And you'll arrive at your ePanel. This is where you can change lots of different elements of your website, and we'll go through that now. The very first option in the left-hand column of the ePanel is General Settings, and by clicking on General Settings, you'll see you have three tabs. These usually are General, Homepage, and Featured Slider. That's if your theme has a featured slider. On the General tab, all these options in this section apply to the overall look of your website. So anything that's changed here will affect your whole entire website. First one is Logo. This is where you can type the URL of where your logo sits on your server. It can be the URL, or you can directly upload an image by clicking on the button that says Upload Image, and choose a file from your computer to upload. Or you can type the URL directly here, or choose a photo or image from your media library. Your favicon, this is the small icon that appears in the menu bar up here in your browser. This is where the URL appears, and next to it there is a little icon. In this case, it's just a standard default document icon, but you can actually make this anything you want. The image size here should be 16 pixels by 16 pixels, and then upload that image to your server, and you can type the URL here, or upload that image by clicking the Upload Image button. The next option is Background Color, and if you click on that box, you'll come up with a color options area where you can just directly choose the color that you'd like, or you can just type in the hexadecimal color here. Just remember to always start it with a hash symbol and then the number of the color. Now, your theme should have different texture or background options, and this is where this will appear here. So you can just click on the default, and you can see in this theme it has quite a lot of different options. If you'd like to change that, just pick one, and then remember to save this at the bottom of the screen, and then view your website. We'll leave it on default for the moment. And that will just change the background texture of the particular theme. Also, you can put in a background image. Now here you type the URL of the image, or you can again can upload the image directly or choose from your media files. In this particular theme, we've got choices of fonts. The header font is the font used for all the major headings. This is either your header ones or the large big type on your website. You can also change the color. Again, this is a hexadecimal color, or pick from the color selector tool here. Remember to start that with a hash symbol if you're just typing in the color directly. The body font can be changed to anything in the list. Again, just pick a font, and then you can also choose a font color here. Again, the same procedure with the color selector, or just typing in your hexadecimal color. The thing to remember at this stage, any changes you make, it's a great idea to go down to the bottom of the ePanel and click Save. None of your changes will take place until you do that. Now, this section here gives you some ways to stylize different aspects of your website. Your blog style post format here, this is to either enable or disable the truncating your blog formats. As a default on your home page, the theme chooses to truncate your blog post so that the whole blog post doesn't actually appear on the front page because that would make it extremely long. If you do actually want them to appear in full, then all you would do is enable this option. This option here is where the theme will take the first image on your blog post page. So if you adding an image to your blog post, it will pick that image to be the main featured image of the blog post. If it's disabled, then you need, as it is in this case, then you need to specify an image in the options in your blog post. This is usually under custom elements, and you can just type in the URL of the image that you'd like to appear as the main image for your blog post. Show Twitter icon. These social media elements here only appear on themes where it is enabled. So either simply enable it or disable it, and it will show Facebook, Twitter, and RSS icons. And if it is social media is enabled on your particular theme, these next sections are where you would type your Twitter profile URL, which goes directly to your Twitter profile. Your RSS feed URL goes here. This is to your RSS feed to your blog. And your Facebook profile URL goes here. Next options simply determine how many blog posts will appear on each category page, how many blog posts appear on each archive page, how many blog posts appear in the search results when visitors search on your website, and how many blog posts appear on tag pages. If you're not sure about any of these, just leave them as default. This next section is the date format. This just determines how your date appears on your website. So for example, this is the month, the day, and the year, which is an American way of stating the date. If you want to change that to a more European or British, you just change this to J and leave the M and then take that out there, and that will appear as day, month, and year. This next section here is use X for excerpts when defined. This is only applicable to specific themes and different elements of WordPress where the theme will capture a certain section of your blog post and use that to appear on that page. Usually this is disabled, but if you know about excerpts, then you can just enable that here. Show control panel. This should always be enabled, otherwise this ePanel won't appear, so leave that as is. Responsive layout and responsive shortcodes. Responsive layout, if your theme does have a responsive layout, for example with mobile devices, then you can enable that here. If it's causing problems, then disable it. Responsive shortcodes is the same thing, except it focuses on shortcodes which you can use in your design of the websites. And as I say, any changes you make on this screen, just click save. Otherwise, those changes won't take place. Now, the next section we're going to is homepage. So we go back up to the top and click on the homepage tab. The homepage tab is specific to each theme, and these elements tend to vary a little, but the general overall idea remains the same. If your theme has content areas, which are small blocks of text, you can enable this option here. Just click enable or disable it. If your theme has a media section, such as in this particular theme, you can enable or disable it here. If your theme has a homepage quote, you can enable it or disable it here. And below, we just then add in these elements. So if you have a quote line, you have an option of changing that here. If it has a second line, that will appear next. So you just type in what you want to appear there. And if you do have small blocks of text, which are content areas on your website, then you can select from the different pages or posts here. So whatever you select here will appear on the home page in those content areas. The thing to remember about the content areas is if it's a full page that you're wanting to select, remember to go into that page or post and put the more line, the separator line function, where you want it to cut off. Otherwise, the whole page or whole post will appear on the home page. If you have a media bar option, you can set the number of posts that display, and you can select which categories do not appear in the media bar, so you can be very selective about which categories that it picks up and displays on the home page. If you have a recent post displayed on the home page, you can select how many posts are displayed here, and below you can select which categories it will not include on the recent posts. And remember to click Save to make sure the options you've changed take effect. And lastly, in the general settings is the featured slider. If your theme has a featured slider, you can change the elements of it here. The first one, you can either display the feature slider or not by clicking the Enable button. The duplicate featured articles is where your most recent featured posts will also appear in your featured articles in the slider. And this can sometimes cause duplicate issues. This is where you can either enable or disable it, depending on if you're having any issues with that. If your slider has different effects, you can choose from the drop-down list here. You can also choose the featured category. Usually with Elegant Themes, it's a good idea to have a category called Featured. Make sure that you choose that category here. Next, you can choose how many featured slides appear in the slider. And then here you can also use pages instead of posts. If you click this, make sure it's enabled, and then below you can choose particular pages that will appear in your slider. Below that, you can choose to automate the slider animation or disable it. And lastly, you can choose the speed here at how fast it rotates. The greater the number, the slower the slider will work. And remember to save all your options to take effect. So that's a general overview of the general settings in EPanel. And we'll look at navigation in the next video.